Don DeBar recording from Zuccotti Park. You can see behind me, it's a pretty good turnout at about, 1:30 in the afternoon on Sunday. It's into the fourth week of the occupation of Zuccotti Park, and second day of a long weekend that's seen activity all over the country. So we're going to go in and talk to some people and see if we can't get an idea of where things are at today.
Over there.
Very nice movement. They can do this.
I'm
nice shirt.
No, she's older. They brought the place over.
I mean, employers who want to do the right thing.
And we're coming to neighborhoods near you.
And we're coming to neighborhoods near you.
To raise the standards.
To raise the standards.
Beyond the minimum.
Beyond the minimum.
Established by the Bill of Rights.
Established by the Bill of Rights.
We still need.
We still need.
Six days.
Holidays.
Vacation.
Personal days.
Guys, how's it going? Hey, 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 how's it going? What's happening?
I'm gonna go back to the room.
Yeah. Excellent.
couldn't believe. Yeah, do that. There you go.
Usual. Take one picture, take one video. Smile, dude.
How you been?
Pretty good.
I was looking for your email address the other day.
You don't know where.
Where'd you get the? What?
So this is happening. She's gonna
99% so are you.
Oh yeah, you found them. Follow that tall sign.
Yeah.
Question. picture of me and Tom talking about.
I'm like, I can't wait until you get someone with that.
What's that?
Thank you.
Come up from?
South Carolina, Charleston, South Carolina.
You're a postal worker?
Yes, I am, 30 years.
And what do you have to say about what's going on right now?
Unbelievable, knowing how the system works, knowing how the capital corporate greed, not just at the bottom of the job for closing post offices, but the underlying thing is that they're trying to take over the pension plan and the health plan, which absolutely, they drain it from their pockets, millions and millions. Billions of dollars. Let me tell you, people have lost jobs. Where I come from, they hired within the last couple of weeks about 12 people. They hire them at the lower wage.
New tier.
They two-tier. They get no benefits whatsoever.
How long has the Postal Service been in existence now?
Oh, gosh, since the Army Express.
And has it ever faced this kind of cutting?
Franklin was the first Postmaster General.
And has it ever been at jeopardy like it is now in history?
It's not in jeopardy now. It's only in jeopardy because of corporate greed. They can time at all.
That's what
they're
I mean.
Money. Right. We're funding a program for billions and billions. They have to pre-fund workers who are not even working right now. They're working in the future, 14 years from now. That's a lot of money. No other corporation is supposed to do that.
Thank you. What's your name?
Eddie Okendo.
Nice to meet you, man. Yes. And you, where are you from?
I'm from San Francisco, Bay Area.
How long have you been out here?
I've been out here for a couple of days. And I'm a retired Medicare with the Department of Health. And you know, ever since the 1970 postal strike, before that, we didn't have collective bargaining. We had what they call collective begging. People said the union would go to Congress and say, look, we're very deserving, and give us a raise, and they'd give you but then in the 1970 postal strike, we shut down the mail service in the whole country for 4 days. That really woke up the situation. So then we got our first contract with the cost of living and no layoff clause. So that was very important because it meant that throughout the inflationary 70s and later, during the Vietnam War era inflation, the postal workers' wages kept up with the budget more or less. So it came to be the postal service workers making decent wage to support families. And it's very important in communities because you have people who have a steady wage, particularly now. And when people are being laid off, it's very important you have some input on the bus side, postal workers, longshore workers. So now they're trying to destroy the postal service. They're privatizing the big New York banks. And the people who are even on the board of governors in the postal service want to privatize. They want to give it to their friends in private industry. And so that they can have the postal work done by people making less money and pay off the people. So it's a very dangerous situation of closing these post offices. And what's the criteria for closing the post office? 3,700 nationwide. The criteria is, does the post office make money or not? So it's based on the profit model, not the service model.
And it was never formed for that reason.
And you might ask the same of Congress, by the way. You know, Congress doesn't make money either, except for themselves personally, but they serve a public function.
I never understood that. Somebody could spend $3 or $4 million to campaign for a job that pays them $80,000 a year. There's something a little twisted about that.
And then running for president, $1 billion for a job that pays $400,000.
Exactly. By the way, if people don't think the postal service is being privatized, in the southern region where I'm at, if you mail a priority package, it is primarily handled by, guess who?
FedEx. Not even a union shop like UPS. Yeah. Wow.
That's funny. I wore a FedEx shirt to work one time. Somebody wanted to send me home. You work for the post office. Yeah, but you're loading priority mail on a FedEx truck. What do you want from
the post office? The people who ran the post office made an under-the-table deal with FedEx. They put FedEx boxes in front of every post office instead of a collection box. And the other thing, just like you have the profit motive on it, which stations are going to close. So it's just more areas in New York that people are needing to close the service.
Right.
The collection boxes, they're eliminating collection boxes. They create these facilities and they eliminate the ones that have the fewest letters. So what happens is that going to be?
Right, of course, poor neighborhoods. For the remote neighborhoods.
And right now, UPS does, you know, the post office has to deliver to 100% of all the addresses in the United States. UPS doesn't have to do that.
Nobody does, right.
When it's privatized, those people in the poor communities, in the rural communities, the isolated communities, they're in trouble. They're not going to get service because it doesn't pay to do that.
Right, the post office actually treats the entire country as a community, right? If you live in the United States, you're entitled to have your mail delivered.
Right.
And nobody else has that requirement, that overhead.
You still can come up with 44 cents to send a letter. It's the cheapest thing around. You know, there's nothing comparison. I mean, it's gone up much less than everything else.
Yep.
It's a bargain. It's a service. It's a postal service. It's been around since before the Constitution was signed.
Thank you.
time. What was your name?
Joe Pia, retired social worker from Philadelphia.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you, John.
Thanks, brother.
Right,
John, thanks. Good seeing you.
Oh, you see on the side from the